What up, boo? You good, bro?
That's great. All right.
Gotta get the chips and queso for surely. That's like mandatory anytime I go out. Sweet tea. That do look pretty good, though. It's like illegal to not get sweet tea from Mississippi. So the transition was straight for you?
Oh,
like,
yeah.
Just from college to?
I came in. When I got the call, I was like, I really didn't know what to expect, but I was just like open-minded to everything.
Yeah.
It was just like, who could I, like, whenever I get there, like, who could I learn from? What was your hardest thing, transition?
It was just the mental aspect, just coming in and then, like, basically just coming to work out every day.
Right.
And basically learning the whole year. Yeah. Never really, like, being used to that. I'm just used
it
to,
was
like,
just red shirt.
Hopping on and playing. But yeah, it did. That's how I looked at it, like a red shirt right. season. So, like, the next year I'll be ready for whatever. It helped me mentally and, like, helped me as a player. Like, I got to sharpen my tools. And
it was really tough for me.
Like, bro, I forgot about that.
Put in all that work, got there, get hurt. And then I was out for like 2 weeks, so when I got back, I had to jam like, what, it was like 12 workouts in like 16 days?
No,
bro,
sir.
I was in a different city.
No, sir. Mine was kind of stressful, I ain't even gonna lie. Coming out like during COVID and stuff like that, they kept pushing the combine days back and the draft days back. So like I'm working out all summer, thinking I'm gonna do the combine on this day, get pushed back. But it was cool though. I mean, considering I got to stay at home, enjoy my family and stuff.
Thank you. Since you said y'all played in the bubble, like what is like, what was the difference from like playing in the bubble?
Bro, it was super different. So like, first, like the whole season didn't have any fans. Yeah. So it just felt like pickup, like a scrimmage, like a closed scrimmage. Yeah. And then when I got to the bubble, it was just like strictly teams, coaches, and like staff and stuff like that. So it was just, you don't have no choice but to lock in on hoops while you're there. But it was cool. And then when we finally got fans back, it just felt like so good. Like, super different, because you go a whole year without them. And then you finally get them, it's just like, okay, really appreciate it.
Yeah.
You definitely got to create your own energy.
Definitely.
When it's just y'all.
It's the whole grill.
Facts. He said the other one was bigger than this.
Facts.
Send that to my pop. It's all about health and wealth. Ooh. We got the same thing.
How you like Austin though?
Well, it's smooth. I ain't gonna cap. I don't think I wanna leave Texas no time soon.
As soon as I pulled up. It was nighttime, I couldn't even see.
You just looking at the lights, huh?
I'm just coming from Sioux Falls. I'm like, yeah, I can deal with this.
And then I mess around and saw these hills and stuff like that too. I'm like, And then the area we live in, smooth, nice, yeah, like close to everything. I was like, yeah, this might be the move. But the only thing is, we barely been out here since we've been here.
Yeah, we've been traveling. I ain't really had nowhere to go. Well, no time to go nowhere.
Facts.
Been on the road the whole time.
Hopefully we can do a little exploring this summer. Really need to go fishing out here.
Definitely.
Find somebody with some water and a boat.
A boat. Let me find me a nice little catfish, bass.
Somebody can put in a skillet right quick.
Mm-hmm. How you see seeing yourself grow like this past couple years in the league? Like,
I think for the most part, for me, I feel like I grew as an adult. Cause like coming in, I was like 21 years old. I mean, you're still an adult, but it's like you still got the college mindset, stuff like that. And then really like being on my own this year taught me a lot. So like I was always on top of my finance and stuff like that, but it's just like you gotta make sure like everything is taken care of like on your own now. Yeah. So
what was that feeling when you got that call knowing you was coming here?
Man, I was super happy because I had already played with them in the bubble and stuff like that. Right. So I already knew most of the staff, most of the players.
Right.
So it was like I basically told them, like, I feel like I'm at home and I've never been here before. So it's kind of like seeing my family again almost. Yeah. How you feel about it?
I was thinking about like, I get to be in Texas, closer to my family.
True. I was just happy to be back in the South.
Facts.
Man.
Nothing like the South, bro.
It's different. happy to be back around Sweet Tea for real.
You gotta make your own sweet tea, though.
What?
And South Dakota, too, though.
They look at you crazy if you ask for sweet tea.
But now, what'd you think about, like, how Austin, the community, accept Austin Spurs?
Austin show love, especially. I remember when I first got here, when they made the announcement, I had a lot of people hit me, like, on Instagram and stuff, like, glad to have you back, glad to have you here, and all that stuff. Yeah. They've been showing love, and then the crowds have been good and super interactive at the games and stuff like that.
To me, I feel like we got one of the best crowds I've been there. For
yeah. Because it's a pretty big gym. And,
it is.
Yeah. So how you feel being on the two-way, getting, like, to play with the Spurs and stuff like that?
It's exciting, bro. Just knowing who you, like, you getting a two-way call-up from the G League, and then you come leaving the G League to go on to play for somebody like Pop, you know, and the Spurs. So I feel like that's a blessing on top of itself, being able to be a part of the organization and knowing, like, what they did in the past and, like, the culture here, too. Mm-hmm. So it's just special to be a part of the culture.
Yeah, I feel you on that, man.
What about you?
I feel about the same, man. You talk about being able to play for one of the winningest coaches in history. That's a pretty big deal to me, you know what I'm saying?
You know how many wins you gotta have, bro?
What? I'm like, that's a pretty big deal. And it's like to get the call from them.
Right.
Out of all the teams, and you know, they got a winning culture. You know, that's all they used to is winning. So it's like when a lot of people talk about the NBA and talk about structure and stuff like that, you hear the Spurs. I ain't even gonna cap big, bro. There's a lot of food though. A
lot of food.
I had to take it to the crib.
Got to.
Coming back for sure.
I'm definitely gonna be back.